A rabbit has chewed this fruit tree bark, partially cutting the flow of sap. If this is not corrected, the tree might not develop and fruit well. To bypass the affected area, select a 1-year-old branch long enough to correct the problem. Discard the tip and the bottom and leave enough to cover approximately double the length of the affected area. Prepare and clean a healthy area below the damage. Leave a vertical cut below an area free of bark. Open the bark so it can split when the branch is inserted. Repeat the process above the damaged area. These young branches are flexible enough to be bent. Readjust the length of the branch so it is slightly longer and can be inserted inside the cuts. Make a bevel cut at the end of the branch identical to the one used for bark grafting. Taking care to keep the two cuts aligned, make the cut on the upper part of the branch. Keeping track to avoid inverting the normal branch position, place the bottom cut into the bark slot. Bend the upper part of the grafted branch and insert it into the upper bark slot. If you haven't done it yet, remove all the buds along the graft so they don't start growing new branches. To secure the grafts in place, you can use several different methods. A popular one with this type of graft is nailing the branch to the tree to assure a secure fit. Nevertheless, the grafts still have to be protected. If water seeps between the healing tissues, the graft will fail. This type of graft will work with most fruit trees. Nevertheless, since it's usually done when the trees are in dormancy, the bark will not be slipping because the sap is not flowing. Also, with some fruit trees like this peach tree, 1-year wood might not be suitable for the job. 1-year-old branches might be too skinny and full of flower buds. So, you might have to use less flexible 2-year-old wood instead. The grafted branch will grow and it will replace most of the lost vascular tissues. Even so, if the gap is too wide, you might have to do more than one graft. It's easier to remove the buds before placing the graft in place. If the branch is well adjusted inside the bark and you use a strong tape, applying enough pressure, it might not be necessary to use nails. Just to be safe, I usually cover possible water entering points with a resin-based pruning mastic. The undifferentiated cambium cells between the branch and the tree will join, and the vascular tissues will be restored, securing the flow of sap and keeping the tree in good health. Thanks for watching. If you appreciate my videos, like, subscribe, share, and comment to help me make more. Click the bell to receive notifications of new videos.